Time now for the exchange. Joining me is Shelly Palmer. He's a professor of advanced media at Syracuse University and CEO of the Palmer Group. Shelly, it's been a while. I think it's been at least a couple of years since I've had you on my show. So good to see you, my friend. We all know how much AI can, of course, benefit humanity. I mean, we've talked about the breakthroughs in medicine, education. I mean, the list goes on. But when you think about some of the key issues, be it jobs, be it AI chatbots or, you know, ChatGPT, for example, developing harmful relationships with minors. I mean, there was the case in July of the 23-year-old that was essentially goaded. I mean, if you look at the transcripts, he was goaded by ChatGPT to commit suicide. And part of the issue is that, you know, this is an app that tells you literally everything that you want to hear. So just walk us through whether you think at this point the risks outweigh the benefit. That's something that Jeffrey Hinton has talked about.
You know, it doesn't matter what I think. And I think what we really need to do is ground this in reality. There's about $3 trillion that's been lined up behind AI. The United States government made it very, very clear in its AI action plan that they believe we need to beat the Chinese to AGI, which is initialism for artificial general intelligence. There's no agreed upon definition of what that means. Some people say it's when AI can do human level work or above human level work. Others say that it's when it can do economically useful work. But however you want to define AGI, we are, by government mandate, to beat the Chinese there. So while you talk about AI companies and you talk about how you might regulate them, what no one is paying attention to is that this is now the Manhattan Project of our generation, and we have militarized AI. And so as long as that's true, the federal government is not going to want to put any constraints on AI research or AI companies that would in any way slow them down. So that's one thing that's going on. Then we all get to use AI through the consumer interfaces, which, by the way, are nothing compared to what the industrial interfaces are like and what they're capable of. And when you put these things together, you've got two opposing ideas. One is, hey, how does somebody who's very lonely, who's now going to treat ChatGPT as a friend or as a loved one, because it's set up sick to be a sycophant, and it's set up to just cajole you and make you happy, and it's reward-based, so it's going to do that to a person. But on the other side, it's for cybersecurity and putting drones over battlefields and creating battle plans that are better than the other AI-created battle plans. We are in two different worlds here, and to try to separate them into consumer regulation and government regulation for military, it's a really hard problem. And so it's easy to say, let's regulate. Okay, what do you mean by that? That's the question you got to ask.
And there has to be appetite at the government level, as you point out. And if the mandate is we have to win the race against China, there's not going to be much appetite for that. One of the things that Bernie Sanders, especially given his progressive views, obviously it makes sense, he's focused on what AI will do to jobs. He says, and I'm quoting here, if there are no jobs and humans won't be needed for most things, how do people get an income to feed their families, to get healthcare or pay the rent? And he mentions, I think this is critical, that there's not been one serious word of discussion in Congress about that reality. Do you agree? And what should Congress be doing on that front?
Okay, first of all, Congress is not paying any attention in class. So that's not new. Everything that has to do with technology, this is not a group that cares much about. It's important to think about where we are and where we're going. AGI, however you describe it, artificial general intelligence, platforms that can do human level work, if that's your definition, or ASI, artificial superintelligence, which would be more intelligent than we are and able to do things we cannot do or cannot conceive of. If you believe these things are going to be possible, and I do, the question is, what's your timing? So right now, AI is not taking anybody's jobs. You're not going to find a job that's removed by AI. Some menial clerical tasks are being taken up by AI. You can call it agentic tools or tools with agency, or you can call them agents or autonomous agents. These are small little bits of AI that can do things like summarize an email, send an after action report, do a proposal. When you talk about losing a full job to AI, we're not there yet. At any moment, Zane, and I mean at any moment, on any day, today, tonight, tomorrow, we could achieve AGI, and that would literally change the world. You have to time that.
Shelly, I'm so sorry. I am out of time. I wish I could literally talk about this with you for hours, right? You're fascinating and I love your mind and I love speaking to you, but I do have to go.
Thank
Shelly
you.
Palmer, appreciate you joining us. Happy New Year, my friend.